And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَتَبَ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. He obligated himself with mercy subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the rahmah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, we have ar-Rahman, we have ar-Rahim. Let's understand this point before I leave now. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He obligated Himself with mercy, to be the God of mercy. And His mercy, it is in this worldly life for the Muslims and non-Muslims, as I said. That's why when we say in the Quran, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, He is ar-Rahman of the dunya and ar-Rahim of the akhirah. You understand it? That's why Allah said about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, بِالْمُؤْمِنِينَ رَعُوفٌ رَحِيمٌ. For the only Rahim for the mu'mineen. And the Rahman for the everybody in dunya. That's why Allah is still feeding, as I said, those who are denying Him. He's still giving them oxygen. They can breathe. Water, can drink. And the water and the oxygen, Allah did not give it to anybody from the human being. Otherwise, people will die. This is for to guarantee this economy. And in the hereafter, Allah is Rahim to the mu'mineen. And Allah will, in His court, in the hereafter, He will punish the disbelievers and those who are disobeying Him. And He will reward the mu'mineen and those who used to obey Him during their lifetime. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us here something we have to understand, al-thawab wal-iqab, the punishment and the reward. Maybe somebody can say, why Allah created us to punish us? No, Allah Rahim. But if Allah punished somebody, He deserved it. Allah said, وَلَا يَظْلَمُ رَبُّكَ أَحَدًا. Allah cannot just punish people like this. No, believe me, wallahi, if Allah punished somebody, He deserved it. Allah's punishment. He deserved it. Yes, this is the only thing for him to be fixed, to punish him. Yes, sometimes you have a little child and he's giving you a hard time. And if you put the gun just like this in the table, say, Daddy, I said, yeah, Habib, give me the gun, I want to play. And the gun is full of bullets. If you give him the gun, everybody in the house, he's going to chick, 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 chick. He's going to kill everybody because he's stupid, dumb. He doesn't know nothing. And the kid is not just stupid, his dad is stupid too. Because he gave him the gun. But if you tell him, this is not yours, you bring it to me. Huh? Don't ask for this anymore, don't touch it. And you became harsh a little bit with him, you're going to be polite. You're going to know, don't touch this. But sometimes you have to be harsh when you educate, when you raise, when you little bit, to make them, to put them in the right way. But nowadays our kids like Kentucky chicken, and the McDonald's kids nowadays, you know, they are crying from anything. They cannot carry anything. They are not patient like us. We grow up in our countries with harshness, to be honest with you. We used to go to the field helping our fathers, feeding the cows and feeding whatever, and working hard, carrying a lot of stuff when we were little, you know. So I remember that. And we became men, real men, yes. But if you give everything, I'm not saying to be harsh in a bad way, to teach, to raise up, to grow up your kid in the right way. If you give him everything, this is not right. It's not good. That's why Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَا تُؤْتُوا السُّفَهَاءَ أَمْوَالَكُمْ وَابْتَلُوا الْيَتَامَى. ابْتَلُوا الْيَتَامَى, you have to examine them. For you give them money, to me, ayat in Surah An-Nisa'. The point here of this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's putting the thawab, the reward for those who are obeying Him, Jannah inshallah, and the iqab, the punishment for those who used to disobey Him. But in general, He's feeding everybody in this dunya, everyone. قال إن الله لما خلق الخلق كتب كتابا عنده فوق العرش إن رحمتي سبقت غضبي. الله أكبر. That hadith saying, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have created His creatures, His khalq, everyone, and He wrote a book, and that book above His throne. What did He say in that book? He said, "Inna rahmati sabaqat ghadabi." I put my mercy before my punishment.
My mercy first. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, كَتَبَ رَبُّكُمْ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ الرَّحْمَةِ. That rahmah for the mu'mineen, jama'ah. And Allah, after that, He declared for us the punishment for those who are denying the resurrection day. These people, they lose themselves. Why? Because of their disbelief. That's why. Ya jama'a, hafzu ala ni'am rabbina bta'atu. Guard that ni'mah which is Allah gave it to you by obeying Allah. See, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving you rizq and giving you too many of His bounties, and you are giving zakah, taking care of this money, giving the rights of Allah, the rights of the people, and you are not making mischief with this money and power on the earth, Allah will give you extras. Allah will give you barakah. Allah will increase this barakah in your life. But if you misuse that power which is Allah gave it to you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take it back from you and you're going to lose yourself. Yes, that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the ayah clearly, الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Because of their disbelief, they lose their own selves. Because of their what? Disbelief. And because also of your sin, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sending His punishment and taking His khayrat away from you. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, إن الله يحرم تكبيرة الإحرام خلف الإمام بالذنب يصيبه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can deprive you from being coming behind the Imam since he say Allahu Akbar because of your sin. قال إن العبد لا يحرم الرزق بالذنب يصيبه. Allah can deprive you from His risk because of your sin. Your sickness because of your sin. It's not working with you because of your sin. Because you're not coming to the masjid, because you're not guarding your salawat. You are away, astray, and you're asking Allah, how Allah can help you? That's why the ayah is very clear, الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. Because of their disbelief, they lose their own selves. Yes. These people, they lose themselves because their hearts became very dark and blocked. Blocked means what? There is no iman going into their hearts. And there is no disbelief will go out of their hearts. And Allah mentioned that in the Holy Quran. Those who lose their own selves because of their disbelief, their hearts became locked. Allah locked their hearts. Allah put ran, covered their hearts with ran. Ran, yani sin above sin above sin above sin, became blocked like this. If somebody, his heart became like, Allah blocked their hearts, means what? There is no iman will go through in, no light will go into their hearts. And if they have kufr and disbelief in their hearts, that kufr and disbelief will not go out. That's why they lose themselves. Because of what? فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. Ya Rabb, why they lose their own selves? He said, because فَهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, because of their disbelief. They are not believing in Allah and Rasulullah and the Quran. وَذَلِكَ بِإِبْطَالِ الْعَقْلِ وَإِصْرَارِهِمْ عَلَى الْكُفْرِ. And these people, they're gonna be blocked their intellect. There is no wisdom anymore. And they're gonna be stubborn in their disbelief. And they're gonna imitate their forbearance blindly, like the kuffar of Quraysh. Rasulullah said, believe. They said, no, 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 we are imitating our forbearers. Inna wajadna aba'ana ala umma, wa inna ala atharihim muqtadun. That's it. They follow them blindly. No, try to think. Use your intellect. Very important. This is, I think this is enough tonight, inshallah.